Praise God, my dear friends. Welcome to another edition of Times of Refreshing. It is such a great joy for me to come and speak to you from the Word of God. Today we will be talking about the power of praise. Paul and Silas were in prison, but the prison turned into a place of revival, a place where souls were saved, a place where they were set free. Whatever you are going through today, you may be in a bondage or financial difficulties or sickness, whatever you are going through, as you listen to this message, God can set you free as well. May God bless you as you listen to this message. Praise the Lord, my dear friends. Welcome to another edition of Times of Refreshing. It is such a great joy and honor for me to come and share God's word with all of you. I pray that as you listen to this message, you will be greatly blessed and your life will be transformed by the power of the Word of God. Word of God, Bible says, is quick and powerful. It is sharper than any two-edged sword. Word of God is fire. Word of God is like hammer. It destroys every obstacles and plans of the devil. So as you listen to the Word of God, I pray that your life will be blessed and you will experience a touch and miracle from God Almighty. I want to talk to you from Book of Acts chapter 16 verse 25 on. It says at the midnight hour, but about midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns of praise to God. Paul and Silas were accused of creating chaos and riots in the city. And as a result of it, people stood against Paul and Silas and they were thrown into the prison cell. Imagine Roman prison cells were maximum prison cells. It was total darkness. It was like a dungeon. No windows, no lights coming in, no mattress or bed. They would have to sleep on the bare floor. They would have to take care of themselves within the confinement of their small little prison. The floor was full of insects. There could be other living beings like snakes or rats. You know, they would be going through that. But in the midst of all that, Bible says Paul and Silas were singing praise and hymns to Almighty God. Their focus was not their problems. Their focus was Lord Jesus. I want to ask you today, as the midnight hour that you are going through, in other words, the deepest, darkest times of your life, maybe it could be family problems or unemployment or financial problems or sickness, whatever the problem is, the deepest, darkest valley of your life, the midnight hour, where is your focus? Where you focus, that's where you experience the touch of God, the miracles of God. Bible says, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Psalms 34 verse 3. What does the word magnify means? You know, when we were in school, the teacher would give us magnifying lens. And then we would magnify an object. Anything that's under the magnifying lens would be blown up 100 times. So you can see this image clearly. Well, the question is, what are you magnifying? Psalmist says, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. We need to magnify the name of God in the deepest, darkest time of our life. I know many of you are going through deep, darkest times in your life. You're going through many problems in your life. But as you are going through the problems in your life, magnify the name of God. God is greater than your problems. God is greater than anything that you are facing or anything that you will face in the future. Bible says, heaven is the throne of God and earth is the footstool of God. You can't even compare who God is by with anything and anyone or any problems that we face. That's how big our God is. That God is saying, I am with you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. The problem that you face today will not destroy you. It will build you up. It will make you mature in the presence of God. But the focus needs to be on God rather than the problem. Focus on God, and you will experience the provision and the power of God in your life. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. See, in the midnight hour, Paul and Silas was praising and worshiping God. Their focus was not the Roman prison cells. Their focus was not the problems or the wounds that they were carrying. Their focus was not the chain that they were experiencing in their life, but their focus was on God Almighty. As a result, what happened? Bible says, as they were praising God, prisoners were listening to him. When you praise God, or when you are going through the problems, and how you react to the problems, many people are watching it. The people around you are watching it. Your neighbors are watching what you are doing in the midst of the problems that you face. As a child of God, the problem could be great, but you need to walk as if you're not walking alone. This is not a theology, but it should be an experiential thing in your life. This should be your experience. No matter what happens, my God is with me, so I will overcome any problem that the world throws my way. That needs to be our attitude. Always remember that there are people listening to you, watching you, to learn from you, to see how you are dealing with it. Hallelujah. And verse 2, it says, as they were praising God, as they were lifting up the name of God, they experienced a great earthquake. Let me tell you, praise brings the presence of God in your life. Bible says, God enthrones in the praises of his people Israel. In other words, God dwells on the praises. When you praise God, the presence of God comes down to your midst. And that's why it's important to praise God no matter what you face in your life. Yes, the problem could be great, but the praise can break every problem that you face. We praise God because God is good to us. God is almighty. God is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Our Lord Jesus is the Lion of the tribe of Judah. And when, as a result of praising God, the presence of God comes down, obstacles are destroyed. Praising God brings the presence of God in our life. And like I always say, when you have the presence of God in your life, there is nothing that you need to worry about in your life. Presence of God is the solution to any and every problem that we face. Let me say that one more time. Presence of God is a solution to any and every problem that we face in your life. When you have the presence of God, sickness cannot stand. When you have the presence of God, financial problems cannot stand. When you have the presence of God in your life, any problem that will affect you, may affect you, or that you are going through will not stand. Why? Because of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Praise brings the presence of God in your life. And as a result of it, praise destroys every obstacle that stands in the way. We see in Book of Acts chapter 16 verse 26, it says, suddenly there came a great earthquake. The prison cell started shaking. Let me tell you, a child of God cannot be held hostage by this world, by devil, by Satan. Hallelujah. A child of God will not be held hostage. When you praise God, angelic presence of God comes. The presence of the Almighty God comes. And that's why it's important to praise God. The great earthquake happened. So the foundations of the prison house were shaken. Everything that's holding you back in your life will shake, will destroy when you praise God. What does worship mean? What does praising God mean? Worship is an expression of love in your life, love of Jesus in your life. Worshipping God needs to come from your heart. It's not about making sounds. It's not about screaming. It's not about yelling. Worshipping God needs to come from the bottom of your heart. Worship will not happen if you don't have a relationship with the one who deserves all the worship. Worship needs to come because of the love of Jesus in your heart. It's an expression of the love of Jesus from you. That's what worship is. Nothing else. So when you worship God, when you praise God, everything that's holding you back will be destroyed by the presence of God, by the praise and worship of God in your life. And Bible says, immediately all the doors were opened. Every doors that are standing against you will be opened when you praise God. Praising God is the key to receiving deliverance from God. Praising God is the key to receiving miracles from God. Are you experiencing bondage in your life? Are you experiencing problems in your life? Then my suggestion to you is focus on praising God, not the problems that you face. Yes, the problems could be great, but the praise has greater power than the problems or circumstances that you face. Bible says Paul and Silas were praising God. All the doors that were against them were opened automatically. The shut doors were opened automatically. Nobody had to do anything. That's what the power of God is. As you are going through difficulties in your life, when the doors are shut against you, like the Bible says here, when you praise God, doors will be opened automatically. I want to declare in Jesus' name, as you are praising and worshiping God along with me today, doors will be opened for you in Jesus' name. All the doors were opened and everybody's chains were unfastened. The people that were around them, their chains were all fell as well. So the key to receiving deliverance for you, and not only you, the other people around you, your family members, your neighbors, is in your hand. Let me tell you, when God sends deliverance to you, other people experience miracles of God in their life as well. When God sends blessing to you, other people will be blessed as well. When Paul and Silas, their chains fell, other people's chains fell as well. So I want to tell you, as you praise God, the place that you're living in will experience freedom as well when you open your mouth and invite the presence of God to come into your life. Hallelujah. I heard about a story from a pastor once. This pastor used to be a servant of Satan. He used to be a priest in the satanic temple. He was saying how he received Jesus into his life. He controlled so many demonic powers in him and through his witchcraft. One day he was passing by the neighborhood after the satanic service. As he was walking by, he was controlling all the demonic forces, so he felt so powerful. But then when he got in front of a house, All the demonic forces in him started shivering and shaking. This man thought, how is this possible? I control the neighborhood. My demonic forces control this place. How is it possible? He looked the opposite side. There was a small little home. And in that home, there was an old man. And he was praising God. He was lifting up the name of God. And every time he said, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, the demonic forces in this man, the priest in the satanic temple, were shaking, and finally the demonic forces left him. The freedom in your life and the people around you and your neighbors is in your hand. The more you praise God, the more you lift up the name of God, the more you lift up cross of Jesus, you will experience the blessings of God. Doors will be opened. Chains will fall. And presence of God will invade in your place, in your family's life. Are you worried about your children? Are you worried about your husband? Are you worried about your family members? Then let me tell you, let me encourage you today. Just praise God. As you praise God, whether you are in the kitchen, maybe when you are working, whenever you get a chance, praise God, and you will experience the blessings of God, and other people experience the freedom as well. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Praising God brings deliverance to not only you, but the people around you. Praising God causes your enemies to bless you. We see, when you read the whole chapter, you can see that the jailer who was the captain of that jail, he persecuted Paul and Silas, beat them, tormented them. They caused bruises in their body. But this jailer became the source of healing. The jailer started applying the medicine to the body of Paul and Silas, taking care of the wounds Paul and Silas experienced when jailer met the power of Jesus. As a result, the jailer became the source of healing and blessing to Paul and Silas. In your life also, you want to experience the blessings of God? Praising God brings your enemies, causes your enemies to bless you. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. That's why praises and worshiping God is the key, is very important in a Christian's life. Bible says our weapons are not carnal. Our weapons are mighty in pulling down every stronghold. One of the weapons that St. Paul is talking about is praising God, worshiping God. It's mighty to pull down every stronghold, every obstacle that the enemy has built against you. In the Old Testament, 2 Chronicles, we see a godly king by the name of Jehoshaphat. Jehoshaphat was a godly man. Bible says in 2 Chronicles chapter 20, he faced a problem. The problem was that he faced enemies that were much bigger than he was. The enemy wanted to destroy the nation of Judah. So the enemies came together as a powerful force, attacking Jehoshaphat. Jehoshaphat did not know what to do. Only thing he knew, that he would go to the presence of God. Bible says that 2 Chronicles chapter 20 verse 3, it says like this, Jehoshaphat was afraid. See, you and I, we're human beings. We get afraid as well. But don't let that fear rule over you. And quickly turned his attention, Bible says, to seek the Lord. When you face problem, the number one thing that you need to do is seek the face of God. Psalms 34, it says like this: those who looked unto him, their faces was radiant. They were never put to shame. See, when you see God, you will not be failure. You will not be put to shame. When you face God, when you see God, when you look at God, God's presence, God's might, God's almighty angelic presence will come to you as well. Bible says like this, the eyes of the Lord is running to and fro throughout the whole earth to show himself strong on behalf of those who are loyal to him. God wants to show you his power to you. God wants to show you his strength to you. God wants to reveal who he is to you. Eyes of God is running to and fro throughout the earth. My dear friend, it doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter what your qualification is. But God Almighty wants to show you his power in your life. In your life. Can you believe it? Can you receive this word? Can you accept? Can you begin to praise and begin to worship God? Don't focus on your problem. Focus on God. Don't let worry drown you. Seek the face of God. Don't be afraid of what will happen to you. Your future is controlled by God Almighty. Don't say that nobody loves me, nobody cares about me. Bible says that God knew you when you were in your mother's womb. God has a plan for you. God has a purpose for you. The purposes and plans of God will never fail in your life. You are precious in the sight of God. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. See, when Jehoshaphat faced problems that were much bigger that he could not handle, he started facing God, seeking God, and declared a fast. He proclaimed a fast to seek the presence of God. Bible says like this, that God's Spirit started answering Jehoshaphat by saying, you don't need to fight this battle. This battle belongs to me. Well, 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 17, it says like this, you need not fight in this battle. Station yourself. Stand and see the salvation of the Lord on your behalf. O Judah and Jerusalem, do not fear or be dismayed. Tomorrow go out to face them, for the Lord is with you. That's what happens when you praise God. God takes over your battle. God takes over your problem. And then all you have to do is just stand firm. Just be confident. Just be courageous. God is with you. That's what God told Jehoshaphat. And I want to tell you the same thing to you as well today. When you are a child of God, when you are seeking the face of God, don't fight the battle. God will fight the battle for you. Don't answer to all your enemies. God will answer to your enemies. Don't be stressed out about what will happen to you. God will take care of you. If God can take care of the birds of the air, how much more will he take care of you? Hallelujah. Bible says like this, and when Jehoshaphat started worshiping God and praising God in the midst of the greatest battle of his life, enemies started killing each other. Enemy soldiers started attacking each other. The spirit of confusion came over the camp of the enemy. And Bible says that all the wealth of the enemy, all the treasures of the enemy came to Jehoshaphat. It took 3 days for Jehoshaphat to collect all the wealth that the enemy had and accumulated over these years. Hallelujah. See, enemy can steal for a moment, but you have a right to gain everything back thousandfold. You have a legal right as a child of God to reclaim what the enemy has stolen from you. Whatever it is, whether it's peace, joy, your family, everything will come back to you when you praise God, when you worship God. the wealth of the enemy came to Jehoshaphat. I want to tell you, praise causes your enemies to bless you. In the midnight hour, Paul and Silas praised God, and their situation changed. In the midnight hour of your life, when you praise God and when you worship God, your life will change as well. You will experience the provision and miracles of God as well. Hallelujah to the Almighty God. How many of you believe and receive this word today? I want to pray for you. I believe that as you worship and praise God, as you make a decision to lift up the name of God, as you begin to magnify the name of God, as you begin to focus on God rather than focus on problem, God's presence will come down right now. Don't worry about your future. Your future is secure in the hand of God. Don't worry about your financial problem. Heaven doesn't experience a recession or economic problem. You are ambassador of God. You are precious in the sight of God. You are a child of God. You are a royal member. And I pray that this word has encouraged you and it will inspire you to praise and worship God every moment of your life. You don't have to go to church to praise God. Where you are, in your room, you can praise God and worship God. I'm exhorting you, I'm inspiring you, I'm encouraging you to lift up the name of God and worship God, and you will experience the power of God in your life. Now, praising God will bring blessings of God in your life. Praising God will bring freedom to you. Praising God will set the people around you free as well. Praising God will cause your enemies to bless you. May God bless you as you receive this word.
I hope and pray that you have been greatly blessed by the message that you have prayed. If you have any prayer requests, please call the prayer line. The numbers are on the screen. If you would like to send me a message, my number is on the screen as well. God bless you. I want to come to an agreement with you and ask God to heal you, to bless you. The Bible says if two of you agree on earth concerning anything, it will be done. So let's agree that God will bless you. Let us pray. Father, I pray for my dear friend who watches this program. Whatever problems that they are going through right now, I pray that you would touch them in Jesus' name, the name that is above every name. I pray for those who are sick in their body. Lord, your word says, with your stripes, we are healed. We are praying right now for their healing according to your promise, according to your word. In Jesus' name, be healed. I pray for those who are going through family problems. Lord, you are the Prince of Peace. I pray that you would touch them and rebuke every spirit of division, every attack of the enemy in Jesus' mighty name. I pray for those who are financially struggling. Lord, I pray that you would bless them, for you are the provider. You are the Jehovah Jireh. Thank you, Lord God, for answering all our prayers. I bless each and everyone who listen to this program. Let your name be glorified and exalted. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. Well, God bless you. Until I see you next week, may God's presence be with you.